This is Blues View. Coming up, we preview the return of David Gold and David Sullivan as Birmingham City take on West Ham. Hello and welcome to Blues View. I'm Paul Bradley and I'm joined in our Fort Dunlop studios by Colin Tatham. Hi Colin.
Hello.
First up, the West Ham game, we're going to preview that today. Another vital one for Blues. It really could make a big difference to how their season's going to go.
Absolutely. After beating Blackpool, getting a good draw at Villa, they need to keep the run going. They need some level of consistency. And this time a year ago, this is when the Unbeatables, that's when they became the Unbeatables, they started on that incredible run. And it was built on the back of a must-win game, which, you know, Sunderland, this time it was Blackpool, and then going to Villa, they needed to get something there to boost the confidence, and they've done that. So I think they're in decent fettle. They'll go into the game on a bit of a high, but as you said, it's such a key game. I mean, if they can win it, they will do themselves a power of good, and then I think that can really, really transform their season, and they could kick on.
And what will McLeish be saying to his players now after those two good results to kind of drive them on for a good result against West Ham?
Simply just do what you've done. Obviously, they don't want to concede. They want to have a good shape and solid. But again, he's looking for a little bit more in the final third of the pitch to give them a bit of breathing space, to get ahead in the game. And with Jerome and Beausejour now back in harness, they'll have another week's training. That'll be interesting because he'll have some extra firepower, some extra options there. And with Chleb and Zigic sort of getting better and finding their feet by the game, I think in that respect, in the final 30, it is looking a lot healthier than it was at the start of the season when it was very much cough, cough, splutter, splutter.
And what about West Ham? They look like they might be there for the taking, the bottom of the table. They've only got 6 points so far. Will Blues look at them like that, maybe, that they are there for the taking?
I think they will partly think that, but they'll also respect them. They have got some good players when it's all said and done, but it just isn't going for them. And I think, you know, the last time out they had a good performance at Arsenal, but they lose very late on. And when things like that happen, and you're at the bottom of the table, you begin to think, well, are we doomed? It's happened to them before, 2003. They had a fantastic squad, but they went down. And I think, you know, they're under so much pressure there, and there's a lot of attention on them, and of course, with the owners there as well. I think it's a bigger game for them than it is for Blues. If Blues beat them, they'll go 8 points clear, and even at this stage of the season, that's a big margin. And the psychological effect of them losing and remaining bottom, that would be absolutely massive.
Now, I touched on it a few minutes ago. It's going to be the return of David Gold and David Sullivan. Firstly, do you think they're going to come along to the game to watch? And secondly, if they do, what sort of atmosphere is it going to be?
Yeah, that's a good point. Nobody's really thought of that, whether they would actually come and turn up. I'd be surprised if they don't. Birmingham fans will be very volatile. They will be pretty hostile towards them, but I don't think they'll step over the line. They spent 16, almost 17 years at St Andrews, and it was a shame the sour way it ended and the shenanigans that went on. But the bigger picture, I think, overall, they will be grateful for what they did do for the club. But you know, as we say, at football, you know, people are quite fickle. They're the enemy now. They're behind the Carson Young regime, and of course there was a bit of a spat between the old and the new when the takeover was happening. So it all adds to a real spicy fixture, and with the relative positions of the teams as well. I mean, it's what football's all about. That there's a sideshow, there's an important game. Let's get it on. I can't wait. I think it'll be a fascinating afternoon.
Great. Well, thanks again today, Colin. And thank you for watching. We'll be back on Monday with full analysis of that game. See you then.